Welcome back everybody. Just trying to get a bit more organised. Now I've got a little bit more space. Got to decide which of these I'm keeping. This here is just the right height for wedging on. Yeah, so I'm still trying to do my little tribute to Phil Rogers. Little bit text on Bun Chong. If you guys aren't familiar with it, it's a form of traditional Korean stoneware with a blush green tone. Pots are coated with a white slip and decorative designs are painted on using iron pigment. This style of stoneware arose in the 14th century and continues today. I don't quite know where the greenish is going to come from. It's a black slip with a bit of iron oxide in it, but yeah, I'm keeping the iron oxide decoration very basic. This one is going to have wood ash on it. I've put some grooves in it, so hopefully the ash will pull nicely in those. This is just terracotta that's going to have a temaco over the top and then swiped through. That's my attempt at squaring off a bottle. Get it similar to this. I know Phil used a press mold for his, but I threw this and then altered it on the wheel and then added the top section. So we're going to have another go at one of those folks and hope that the camera keeps filming. I've already tried. I did this, filmed me doing this one here, but when I looked at the phone, it had switched itself off. So not sure what's going on there, folks. Get the lamp plugged in. Should stay filming. Now it's got a memory card in it. Yeah, I've not done. Squared off pots, I don't think. That's a little bit more difficult than I thought it was going to be. What I was thinking of doing was just throwing a cylinder and then when it's leather hard, paddling it to square. But I'm going to do what I've already done. And that's alter it on the wheel. Try to. It's a stiff lump of clay, folks. Too soft to use yesterday, so I left it out overnight. £4 lump. Exercise for the day.
the stool.
I did one of the slip decorations with a stoneware, white stoneware clay body and bore clay mix, and the one on the squared off jar vase is feldspar with a little bit of bentonite. Fine just using feldspar on its own. Quite difficult. It's a strange thing once it's mixed with water. Try and get the walls quite thin, folks, because definitely there's going to be no trim in a squared form. Along those lines, find my trimming tool. Level that top off. so I'll do this how I did the other one. We'll try to, folks. Move your chair out of the way. Right, just to get an idea of the square. With my throwing stick up the corners. Maybe a better way than doing it like this. Without a press mould. And then when it's leather harder, I'll try and refine it with my paddle. My wheel would stay still. Yeah, it will need paddling as well. At this stage, I'll leave it at that. Throw the next section. So once it's paddled, hopefully these edges will look more squared off. Now just for the top. Oh, there goes both my back pins. Getting lazy, folks, not putting the nuts underneath them to hold them in place. Mainly because the Allen key heads just keep filling up with clay. Too much clay here, but better too much than not enough. I really like how I've filled the necks on these as well, so I'm trying to keep them similar. Just have a look at the size of the vase, try and get proportions nice. This part, quite a slope on it. Some of that clay away, I think. Just get my calipers to make sure I don't take too much. It's not overly wide.
stuck on tomorrow or the next day. They've been to have a firing, a glaze firing soon as well. Just waiting for a slightly milder day. Could be waiting a while.
Everybody, hope everybody's doing well out there. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.